Hello, welcome to Straw Family Farm. I'm Christy. That's also known as RJ. Alright, so let's get on into it in the chapel.
Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward, it is the Lord Christ you are serving.
Corinthians 3:23-24. Pretty much just means work hard. We do work hard, don't we?
Yep.
Yep. And we seek Him in everything that we do. So. Are you vrooming it to the Lord? All right. In the barn stalls, what do we got going on this week? It seems like we've been forever since we podcast, but I think I podcast last week. I'm not sure.
I ain't been on here in about a month.
Yes, you have. It's been like 2 weeks. All right. So
that's
in
half
the
a month.
Stuff.
I was halfway there.
Yeah. In the barn stalls, what up? Chicken nook. Chicken nook. Chicken nook.
Chicken duck. Chicken duck. Behind the dumpster. Chicken truck. Chicken truck.
Not chicken truck. Chicken duck.
Oh.
All right. So tell your story.
Miss Duck had chickens. That's the short.
Okay, but now she also has what?
So the pig has gummy now.
The pig has gummy.
You hear smacking. Oh.
Okay, so the duck also, Miss Duck also has what?
Four ducks and chickens.
Now, something happened with one, because she had three chickens. You started it again, didn't you?
I gave her a gummy. She loves them.
She goes crazy for them. Go over there and get her ball and put a little feed
she'll
in
stop,
it.
She'll stop.
I still hear it. She's sucking on everything, looking for more. She had three chicks. Now we have to back up because why would she have the chicks first?
Because chicks only take 21 days to hatch. Ducks take 28.
That's right. So she faithfully sat on the nest. Three chickens hatched, and then
she kept setting,
and she did the best to protect the chicks. But unfortunately, what got one?
A snake.
Right in front of RJ's face, huh?
Yeah.
And there was really just nothing you could do to stop it. So, one of the little chicks got, I don't know what you'd call it, bit. Yeah, pretty much you just bit it and let it go, but the pressure either squeezed it to death or, but we really don't know. So anyway, it was up running around, snake reached out, that was it. It just died.
Yep.
She kept the other two well protected, and then the ducks started to hatch 3 days ago, Wednesday.
Yep.
Wednesday morning, so 4 days ago. This is actually Saturday. We're recording a little bit early because tomorrow we won't have them. So 3 days ago, the ducks started to hatch. We're gonna get the nest one more week because why? Is there still snakes in there? She's not sitting on them, but then again, it's like been 107 degrees.
She sits on them every night. Every night.
Okay, we get the point.
Yeah, duh. That's right.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's what else awesome. Is going on? We only have three more. Well, that's in the yarn farm. Mm-hmm. What else? Anything else going on? Anything that has to be?
Yeah.
Anything animal?
Yeah.
What?
I don't know, I was just kind of hoping to say, yeah, I got the, yeah.
The pig is playing with the chicken ball more, yeah. Because she gets...
She loves the... The
little gummies. I think she's been fed a lot of people food, because she likes veggie straws.
She's up on the couch for them.
Potato chips, yeah, she
gummies
will...
Included.
She can clear and get on the couch. If you're laying on the couch, she will just jump right up in your lap. Or in RJ's case, right beside him, on top of him.
Right in my
whatever.
Belly.
Yep. So, but she's, Miss Charlotte's getting there, right? Buttercup and her share a space outside, but it's divided because if you remember, Buttercup didn't really take to her, but she's taking to her better now. So, it's okay. All right, mending fences. What did you do today, son? Oh. Well, for the last couple of days. Sorry, we're tired. Somebody rodeoed me last night.
I really get early this morning.
Yeah, he left yesterday and didn't come home until 5 o'clock this morning.
It was 6.
5:30 this morning.
Something like that. Yeah. It was daylight.
Yep.
And I mean like daylight.
Yep, it was 5:30 this morning.
As in, pull the blinds, folks, so you can get some sleep. You did it, pig!
Okay, so, anyway, hey, keep it down over there. Okay. So, in the barn stall, mending fences.
Yeah.
What did you fix today? Have you been working for like last 2 days? There was a big storm.
Yeah, there was.
And what happened?
It blew some stuff around. I had to go get a barrel like a quarter mile away.
It's stuff that it shouldn't blow around.
Right.
I mean, there were some feed troughs and some feed pans and some buckets, but what blew that you had
it
to
messed
work
up
on?
The red shed roof.
Man pin.
Yeah, man. The whatchamacallit, the doohickey.
Well, and part of that's our fault because first we built the red shed and it had a wooden roof.
Yep.
Then over time we put an old tarp over it because it started leaking. And then we ripped off the old tarp.
Well, mainly the wind took it off.
Mainly the wind took the tarp off.
So
and so we put some tin over it. Well, the wood underneath the tin rotted, so there was really nothing holding it down, correct?
Right.
So, okay, so anyway, there is a pig, and she is underneath our feet. She just likes it up on everybody. She's sweet. She just gets, can you hold up, son?
Can you hold my popsicle?
Yeah, she does like popsicles. Come here. See?
Protest is over, folks.
She gets mad and she wants the entire popsicle. She will like eat it right out of that thing.
Uh-huh.
She's done. Anyway, so fix the red shed. Still gotta get the alternator on Nelly done, don't we?
Yeah, new one.
Yeah, gotta get the new alternator and then we can get it bolted up. And for Grandpa's old truck, Dad still hasn't fixed the transmission filter, has he? So, he's supposed to be working on that. I'm hoping one day he'll do that, huh?
Maybe.
He started it, he just didn't get it done, huh?
Right.
Alright, anything else going on that we've had to fix? Not really. I've been working. Well, that's a farmhouse. In the yarn farm, you have 3 left to shear, right? 3 in the men pen.
Yep.
And they're harder to do because we have to haul the thing out there, set it up, and shear, correct?
Oh, we gotta haul the sheep beats down here.
Yeah. Oh, we gotta haul them down here. So he's been doing, he did Ralphie the other day.
Yep.
And we're just gonna set up like Monday and get it done. So, and then we tried shearing and it rained. How many nights? Like 2 nights in a row?
Yeah.
So none got it done. So, but Hershey's was the final one done. Right. There's no ewes left to do.
Right.
But anyway, so it's getting to June. We should have already had them done, but things just didn't work out. Anything else in the yarn farm?
Yeah.
Yeah, we got the young farmer program that we're starting. Where's Mara?
It's on a trial.
Yeah, we're going to try it. Okay, so the young farmer program, you know, we do interns with teenagers. Wet, you go get her ball and put it in.
She's fine.
No, she's biting me. She's fine with you because she's not biting at you wanting you to feed her. Over there in the corner, I take a little chicken toy and you put feed in it and they roll it around and it drops some out. Don't put a whole lot, just a small handful. Close it up and put it on the ground.
Yeah.
And then she rolls it around as it gets out. She likes it. And she can roll it with her nose, gives her something to do. You don't have to do that, just put it down. See? Well, you guys can't see, but she just starts rolling it around with her nose. And her little tail goes 90 to nothing. Okay, I said I wasn't going to do this so we didn't have to adjust the camera. But there she goes, off the ring. And it's just a ball, and it drops feed out. So, anyway. Alright.
You're gonna make her fat.
No, I'm not. I'm gonna keep her calm while we finish podcasting. So, we do interns with inner city youth, right? Mm-hmm. And they come out and they do stuff. And then we're good. We've got a couple of young kids that are really interested in doing something, and they can't wait to be the intern age. So we've put together a little thing, and we're gonna have a young man be the first to try it out. We call him Mr. T. He's been out here several times. Loves it. Does all kinds of stuff with us, huh? He's even bottle-fed a calf for us. So the five things with the program, they get 5 free admission. It's not an ongoing thing. They get 5 free admission. They can either choose to do everything all in one admission or do a little bit in each admission. It's up to them. But they'll learn poultry care, where they'll have to clean the coop and gather eggs, and we'll teach them about healthy chickens and blah, blah, blah. Another thing is they're going to learn horse care. We'll be with them and clean a stall, and it's one-on-one. It's a child and one of us in each step of this. And then they'll learn how to groom a horse, right? And clean the stall. And then gardening, they'll weed a bed and plant some seeds, and we'll talk about growing good food and all that stuff. Then watering and feeding, we might feed the chickens, might feed the cats and dogs, but we'll clean waterers and discuss how everybody needs good and clean. All the animals and humans need good, clean, healthy food and water. And then for the sheeping, we'll do a sheep and goat section where they will learn about wool processing, how to trim some horses' hooves. RJ will help them with that and show that, you know, there's animal care to go with it. And then shearing, they won't shear, but they'll learn that they have to shear. And then they'll come to me and learn about wool and make a batch. They'll get a certificate of completion when they complete all the tasks or all the segments of the Young Farmers Program. Once they complete those, like I said, they can come out here and maybe spend an hour and do it. This is mostly for local kids. We've got towns 10 miles either way, north or south, and there's inner city kids there. So if they want to do that, they get 5 free admissions to accomplish the tasks that they have to get for the certificate, and then we will put it in the local newspaper. Well, we'll submit it to the local newspaper. We can't make them print it, but we'll submit it to the local newspaper that this is how what they did for their summer. So, and it's for young kids. It's not for, I think our interns are, what, 13 and up? So this would be for children 12 and under. Yep. And we can make it a little bit harder for the older ones and a little bit easier for the younger ones, correct? Uh-huh. So, but it's called the Young Farmers Program. And we're going to try it out.
It's a whole bag.
Bite it in half and give some to the pig.
I'm not going to share.
But anyway, so that is in the making, and Mr. T is going to come out and try it, right? All right, anything else in the yarn farm? Huh? What? You keep saying yes, but we need to move on because you got rodeo to get to, don't you? Mm-hmm. All right. In the fields. I haven't done a garden update. I've been doing that today. We had squash bugs get to my zucchini. RJ went down there and harvested what he could. I got a couple of squash, but we'll see. Or a couple of zucchini. We'll see if anything else makes it out of that. Here's the thing, I bought the plants. I didn't raise them myself, and last year I raised them myself and didn't have any squash bugs, did I?
Right.
So I'm pretty sure that, because I got bigger ones, I think they might have already been in the plant. What?
Squash bugs ate your zucchini.
Zucchini is also known as a squash.
Wouldn't they be called zucchini bugs?
No, because they didn't eat the squash. We don't have any squash, but zucchini is also known as a summer squash. Zucchini is also known as a summer squash.
Okay, you win this one. But
yeah,
we don't squash have squash. Bugs. How do we have squash bugs?
Here's the thing. How come you didn't squash the squash bugs before they even got going?
Oh, I tried to squash them. I did go baseball bat. I was just swinging it on the other day.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, you fixed the fence too. Where the thing back to mending fences. You actually meant fences, didn't you?
To keep the goats
out of the gardens.
Yeah.
Alright, anything else?
Yeah.
What?
this Dilly Whopper.
Oh, that's in the farmhouse.
Well, let's go to the, in the farmhouse because we got nothing else to do.
I was getting there. I asked you if there was anything else in the field.
All right, now we're in the farmhouse, folks.
All right, in the farmhouse.
Mom made this Dilly Whopper.
On the porch. On the
you
porch.
Said that was in the farmhouse. Guys, did she not just say that was
okay,
in the farmhouse?
You have to do in the farmhouse first.
Oh.
Okay, so what do you have going on in the farmhouse? Talk about your rodeo. Talk about it. Hey, 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 talk about it.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey,
did you rodeo last night? Did you rodeo last night?
No, we just had a long ways away last night. For nothing.
Oh, don't hurt me now.
We just went a long ways away for nothing.
What's that mean? You went to a rodeo.
Yeah, but it didn't do any good. So.
And you're ready to go to a rodeo here in a little bit, right?
Yep. About now.
Okay. So I have my glasses back on, but it's temporary, right?
Yeah, four eyes.
I went back to the eye doctor. She switched up and tried giving me a bifocal. And RJ, what happened when she gave me the bifocal contacts?
Gave my migraines and all kinds of good stuff.
Yes, after about 3 hours, it made me feel like I'd been looking through one of those little kid viewfinders, if you remember this from the 70s. And it made my
those
head.
Those are that old. Man, you're old.
And then it made my eye feel like it was going to pop out. So I went back to the eye doctor today,
all right, folks,
that was Wednesday.
Wow, that didn't pop out.
That was Wednesday when she switched them. I didn't last 2 days in those bifocal things. And then, and she told me, she says, I've never had anybody have that kind of reaction. She says, you may have just had a headache that was intensified by the fact that we changed your contacts. But she changed me back to my other ones. I went today and got them all ordered. I also picked up a pair of really cool pink glasses. They're like just the top. Frames, there's nothing on the bottom, but they're pink. That's an old pair that's got a little busted thing. Quick.
I was being Elmer Fudd.
Yeah.
Or whoever
anyway.
That guy is, it looks down his nose. Who is that guy? It's not Elmer Fudd.
No, it's not. But anyway.
Gomer Pyle.
No. No. I don't know who you're talking about. Santa Claus has glasses.
Pig nose. Pig understands.
But anyway, the glasses are temporary. I have my contacts. But I don't like them, and I'm not going to put them in until I get my new ones. So my new ones are ordered. I just want to say this, that if you have VSP or VSR or something, our insurance is amazing. I paid $34 for my eye exam and two trial pair of contacts. Then I got my prescriptions out of that eye exam, so it was like $34, just done. And then of course she fixed my stuff. I've had 3 visits with her for $34. And then when I went and did my glasses and my contacts, I got a year's supply of contacts and a prescription pair of glasses for $35. That's it. So I have less than $100 in, it's like $70, 70, right? 30. 34 and 35 is what? And some change. So we'll say 35 and 35 is 70. So $70. And I got my
glasses. So for $69.99, folks, it could be yours if the price is right.
I got my glasses and a year's supply of contacts. So I'm pretty amazed. We used to give how much for your glasses? Just for a pair of glasses plus the eye appointment.
Oh.
Daddy's glasses work. Come on. Please stop. I'm hot and sticky and I don't need you laying on me.
I'll lay on Fred.
Good. We used to give, I think it was like 100 and something just for his glasses. And it was almost 300 for Dad's glasses. And then we got this new insurance and I am really liking it. So, anyway. Alright. Anything else in the farmhouse? Huh?
Fred doesn't like that. Oh, Fred doesn't say that's me, Bob. Bob doesn't like that. Bob doesn't like that. You just keep poking right through his gut.
Right. His gut is up
here. Yeah, he's big. He's a big guy. He's real tall. You're poking right in the belly. Right in the belly. He's ticklish, too.
Okay. Anyway, all right, anything else going on in your life?
Nope.
Monday, are you getting a new horse in?
I think so.
And you sent one home already,
yep.
Right? So you're still riding outside horses.
Yeah, I think I got another one going home, so.
You got another one going home. Dunny?
Yep.
Okay, how's he doing?
All right.
Doing much better now that it's not hurting, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Oh, it's time.
It's Daily Whopper, which she's going to tell you about, folks.
I'm not really that excited. It's just what I've been working on.
Well, it was mainly what was laying out, so I was told to get it. We should tie that to the pig.
No.
We should bet on the pig.
No. Okay,
it's the size to make for the pig. We need to shrink it down some.
Very funny. Anyway, my front of my shirt, and it's not really a shirt. It's a over thing or whatever.
I say it's kind of a summery deal. I mean, it's kind of.
Yeah. Well, and it's going to be a cold shoulder type. And it's going to have a back.
She's going to give you guys cold shoulder.
So I've just got a couple more rows to do. Short rows is what I'm calling. There's 12 of them across there. And then I am going to start with the back. And it will not be so low. It'll be straight across. So that way it'll be up there like that.
She's going to give you guys the cold shoulder. Just wait.
No, I'm not.
Oh, hey, pig.
No, I'm not. But anyway, I've been doing that, ripping out, and I hadn't brought it out and showed it to you for a while, so I did.
Oh, piggy, piggy.
Anything
loves
else?
Me.
I know, she's back. And if
she
you don't get
loves
on, I'm
me.
Hot. It's hot. What temps have you been around here in Oklahoma?
It's like 100.
Yep. Like 100.
The index is
100.
Like 102, 103 every day.
Yep. So.
It's 95, 96, I believe.
Yep. And you didn't get an air conditioner this year because yours died, huh? It wouldn't work.
So. It had a massive stroke.
We gotta go pick up a new
brain dead.
Window air conditioner, correct?
Oh, big baby.
I know.
You can suck on my knee as long as you want, but there's nothing
anytime
I can do.
Anytime that she, because she's still a baby, she was born April 1st, they said. And she's just, what, April?
Yeah, anytime
May,
she wants something to eat, she starts sucking
on. So, yeah, anytime she wants something, she'll suck on your pants or she'll suck. Sometimes she gets skin and she bites. And I have on Capri's little half pant and she gets my skin and it hurts. She doesn't mean to. She just tries to suckle. But
she's still a baby.
Yep, definitely still a baby.
All right, folks. That's
all
it.
Right, we're gonna call it. Why are we making this short and sweet and fast? And
so I gotta go.
Yep. And tomorrow you gotta do what?
Go to another open and rodeo.
Yep. And you say happy what to everybody for
Happy time? Father's Day.
To all the fathers out there. Right.
Yep. Happy Father's Day to everybody. I don't care who you are. Just have a happy day.
There you go. All right. We'll see you next time, guys.
Peace out, Girl Scouts.